subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get the latest updates.
Most of us are familiar with corals and coral reefs and how important they are to a marine ecosystem. Coral reefs are often called the rainforests of the sea because they are incredibly biodiverse. They are the biggest marine biodiversity hotspots and are in fact more biodiverse than any other ecosystem on the planet, including rainforests like the Amazon. About 25% of all marine species live on the planet around coral reefs. And these reefs host a wide variety of microbial organisms as well in symbiotic relationships where there's mutual benefit to both the coral as well as the microscopic organism. But now scientists have discovered something mysterious. There seems to be a microbial parasite that lives in corals all over the world. In this video, we'll discuss what this parasite is, what scientists think it is, how they discovered it, why it is so biologically mysterious, how it seems to be gathering a lot of energy with no way to release it, and what the existence of these coralicolids mean. I'm Sandhya Ramesh and this is Pure Science. A coral reef is not a naturally existing structure. It is built by corals and is made of calcium carbonate because it's a skeleton. Corals belong to the phylum Cnidaria, where animals come in two forms. The polyps, or the more mature medusa. A jellyfish is an example. Polyps are cylindrical and are the base body of the creature, which develops after fertilization. When these creatures reach sexual maturity, they often transform into an adult medusa with all the tentacles, so medusa. But the class that sea anemones and corals belong to come only in the polyp stage. So individual corals, even mature adults, are all coral polyps and they build these reefs. They live in colonies. Coral polyps also do have tentacles. We can see them very clearly in marine time-lapse videos. These tentacles are retracted during the daytime, but at night they are out to catch plankton or other small creatures or fish. All the coral polyps in a colony are genetically identical. They build these reefs, which is actually their exoskeleton. Coral polyps build exoskeletons by extracting calcium carbonate from the seawater that they live in. The individual polyps live on these exoskeletons of the individuals who came before them, and then they add their own exoskeleton to the reef structure. Coral polyps are sessile, which means that they are attached to a surface throughout their lives. The entire process of reef building takes centuries and centuries, and reefs are found all over the globe in all oceans. The biggest and most well-known of these is, of course, the Great Barrier Reef of Australia. How corals feed is very interesting. At night, they do spread their tentacles out. These are equipped with stingers that can catch even tiny fish by stinging them. But while they can get food this way, a major part of their food and nutrition comes from algae or algae that live inside them called zooxanthellae. These algae live inside the polyps' bodies and they photosynthesize, producing energy for both the polyps and for themselves. In return, they get a home to live in and they also get carbon dioxide. Algae like phytoplankton are the biggest oxygen producers on the planet, so they need carbon dioxide. It is this zooxanthellae that provide the corals with the wide variety of colors that these come in. And corals need a lot of energy to build an entire skeleton around them. So, to facilitate this, they've harnessed this kind of symbiotic relationship as a tool with a wide variety of microbial communities who photosynthesize inside of the corals, from whom they derive their energy to build their reef structure. However, in the past few years, marine biologists have been discovering microbial eukaryotic species in regular genomic surveys of corals. These are ecological surveys to understand what creatures live in and around corals. One of these groups of creatures have been very perplexing and were first discovered in an RNA sequence from corals in a household aquarium. Coral sequences can retain parts of genomic sequences of the creatures that live inside of them, and thus there are thousands of bits of RNA that are from other microbial life found in these coral sequences. These bits fall typically under categories of known algae, but scientists have been discovering thousands of sequences belonging to a group of parasites that are now called coralicolids. Scientists have discovered that there are a number of these type of coralicolids, and some are specific to some types of corals only. Many others are found in creatures that are similar to corals, like sea anemones. What was most intriguing about these coralicolids was that they were colorless. But other symbiotic algae that live inside corals and photosynthesize are not colorless. They capture sunlight using chlorophyll and release energy and colors after photosynthesis. Coralicolids simply did not seem to have any mechanism in their bodies that could perform photosynthesis. During their course of evolution, they lost their ability to photosynthesize. All the genes required for the process were also missing. We don't know much else about them. Do they carry diseases? Many microbes can in fact infect corals and affect their health. We don't know if these are capable of doing that. But what we do know is that these coralicolids do carry genes for chlorophyll, which doesn't make sense. Chlorophyll is used to capture sunlight, and then that sunlight is used in photosynthesis, but these creatures do not photosynthesize. We're also able to tell from how well the genes are expressed or how strong they are when they're purified, whether they are essential or an important component of a creature's life. These essential genes are expressed strongly, and chlorophyll was. This is a big mystery. Why would something have chlorophyll to capture sunlight and hold on to it, but not the machinery for photosynthesis to convert that sunlight to energy and release it? Harvesting protons, as the researchers call it, to release lots of high energy electrons without photosynthesis is basically like a bomb going off. These coralicolids also do not have chlorophyll autofluorescence, which releases the energy. So even though they have chlorophyll, these coralicolids are not performing the function of energy conversion and providing energy to the corals. So what do? We still don't know. The authors of the paper have some theories. Some proteins that are a part of chlorophyll perform other functions in a cell. So maybe there's something that we don't know yet at a cellular level. Or maybe there is an evolutionary pathway in the system that was just retained because there is some other function or outcome which is essential for the survival of the corals. We don't know. But today, the world's corals are threatened everywhere. Coral reefs are extremely sensitive to temperature and acidity, and now they are getting bleached. They are losing their color everywhere, which means that the symbiotic algae that live inside these coral polyps are abandoning these individuals due to the increasing heat and acidification of ocean water. This means that coral polyps do not have enough energy to continue building their reefs and are thus dying out. Understanding these processes and conditions around corals and the microbial life that lives inside of them gives us some aid into understanding how to preserve these crucial coral reef ecosystems better.